Good morning, Eagle Nation. It's Friday. It's Friday, guys. Woo! That's right. Today's the 36th day of school. It's September the 24th, and it's a beautiful day. Wherever you are, wherever you may be, please stop, please stand, and let us rise for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. Okay. All right, here we go. Okay. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Hope you're dressed for success and maybe even a little, wearing a little school swag, some school spirit for today on this Friday. Well, as we continue our celebration of Hispanic Heritage and Latinx month, we want to share with you today, this was submitted by Ms. Sparks. She submitted Roberto Clemente. Roberto Clemente was born in August 18th, 1934, in Carolina, Puerto Rico. Clemente excelled in athletics as a youngster, and at the age of 17, he was playing for the Santurce Crabbers of the Puerto Rican Baseball League. The Dodgers signed him the following year, and by 1954, he was playing for their AAA team in Montreal. This is a quote about him. "Well, I said to myself, there's a boy who can do two things as well as any man who ever lived," said Dodgers scout Clyde Sukforth. "Nobody could throw any better than that, and nobody could run any better than that." Roberto Clemente was the first Latin American player to hit over 300 career hits before his untimely death in a plane crash. If you'd like to learn more about Roberto Clemente, please check out the link above for a biography on his complete life. Today, Roberto Clemente, we salute you. And I want to share with you on this Friday some words of appreciation. This is a card that we received from Banner Hospital across the street to say thank you for all of the cards and letters and the $650 that your neighborhood and your community raised for healthcare workers. They say, thank you all for the outpour of support to our teams. It means so much to our teams to know they are thought of in this way. Charlotte Ciudad. Thank you for your thoughtful gift and notes. We appreciate all you are doing to protect yourselves from COVID. Daniel Post. Your cards and notes have made a difference. Thanks to each of your thoughtfulness. Barb Heibarger. And this one. Thank you so much for your thoughtfulness and generosity. Your efforts really brought a lift to our teams. And some smiles. John Sherp. So thank you to everybody for participating in that. Perhaps we'll have another opportunity to lift their spirits once again. Now let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. And today is on the topic of perseverance. Perseverance. Again, notice that theme keeps coming up. We talked about greed and being greedy earlier this week. I don't know if you've had a chance to use that in your classroom. I did see it in Ms. Burmeister's room up on the whiteboard. So maybe some of you are also practicing playing with words. But today, perseverance. So success means different things to different people. When you are young, success can mean learning how to ride a bike or saving your allowance till you have enough money to buy a new toy or a new cell phone. It feels good to be a success at something. And that's why setting goals is important. When you set a goal and reach it, you feel proud of yourself. You gain confidence. So today, take a minute and set one clear goal you'd like to try and reach this week. Especially with parent-teacher conferences coming up next week, this is a great time to set goals as you look ahead to beyond October break. And your goal could be something small or something at home, like keeping your room clean every day or improving your conduct in class. I encourage you to write your goal down on something and then every day take a look at it as a reminder. If you reach your goal, notice if you feel proud of yourself, and if you don't reach your goal, don't give up. Ask for help. Talk to someone you respect, someone a little older and wiser. Then try again. And remember this.
It's better to try and miss than not to try at all.
With all something to think about, this is Viviana Adames. Make a great day or not, the choice is yours.
Barney's friends are big and small.